Hi friends. So some of you guys might have already seen this video in Malayalam, but you know, for the wider audience, I am considering to do this in English as well. So the basic idea behind doing this video is to, you know, let you guys know, you know, how you can accumulate tools, what tools to buy, and you know, what tools can help you restore these bikes to glory. So, you know, I'll take you guys a bit back in history before I go ahead and tell you what tools I have in our usual fashion of storytelling. So, you know, my love affair with tools have been pretty old. You know, I was 3 or 4 when I held my first screwdriver. So, you know, I mostly get this from my mom. Actually, she was somebody who had this tendency of trying to fix things, but then, you know, I picked up on it and I took it a couple of notches further. So like every you know, young kid in my you know, time frame or in my age circle, I was also banned from buying a motorcycle. So, you know, I spent a good amount of my life without owning one. But I had one in college, you know, borrowed from a friend. So that is what I used to use during college. But then my first and real motorcycle actually happened to come to me in the year 2010. So in the year 2010, when I got my first motorcycle, I also, you know, ended up repairing it myself, because the mechanic who I took my bike to was just behind my house. So, you know, the bike was this RX-100 that you're seeing on the screen. So it was not used for almost 5-6 years. So obviously it wasn't starting. So we took it to the mechanic to just get some help from him and get it started. So the moment he saw the bike, he said that I don't work on these kind of bikes. And I requested him, literally, you know, pleaded to help me start the bike. And he said that he will help me start the bike, but, you know, he won't do anything further than that. So I said, okay. So what he did is he took some petrol out of one of his bikes. And after that, he mixed some of the 4-stroke oil that he had in his workshop into that petrol, and then he poured it into the carburetor after cleaning the carburetor, and the bike came to life. So after that, it was kind of you know, one-man journey fixing this bike. So, you know, I started accumulating tools one by one. So It actually took a few years to get where I am right now, and I would not recommend you guys to, you know, straight away go and buy all the tools I have, because, you know, all these tools which I have are purely need based, and they are not something that I, you know, got on day one. So day one started with pretty basic hand tools. So I'm going to introduce you guys to some hand tools that, you know, I started my journey with. So the first set of tools that I bought, like everybody else, was, you know, a set of spanners or wrenches that, you know, most of you guys are already familiar with. So this is my collection of spanners that I, you know, collected over a period of time. So the biggest spanner that I have is this, but that is not the spanner that is most useful. So this is the most useful, biggest spanner that I have. It's a 27-24 that is used to take the sprocket nuts from and the half axle from an RX-100, RX-135, RD-350, Suzuki Shogun, Samurai, etc., etc. RD-350 has a 30mm rear, you know, nut, half axle nut. So this is my 22-20. So the 22 in this is most useful. That is what comes handy while, you know, taking apart the rear axle, the center axle of an RX. So I have two of these. So obviously one is less used. The next one is an 18, I think 1820. This is used for the front axle on an RX. Next is 17. I have two of those. Then the next one is 16. So the 16mm and the 17mm are little useful. Like the front T-stem bolts of an RD350 can be taken off using a 16mm spanner. So these are useful. Then the next is 14-15. This is a ring set. I have two of these. 15 is a less common size, while 14 is a very common size. So I have a different set of 14, a combination spanner. So this spanner is specifically bought to open the cylinders of an RX. These are called open-ended spanners. These are called ring spanners. This is called combination spanner. So I have two of these 14mm combination spanner. So then the next one that I have is a 12-13. It's again a very useful spanner. I have both the open-ended and the ring set. The ring set is slightly multi-purpose. It is also a little bent so that I can use it in tight places. Then I have a 11, which is not very common size. Then I have a 10-11 ring, which is again not very useful. But the 10mm combination spanner is one of the most useful tool in my spanner set. So I use it a lot. Then there is an 8mm, and then there is a very small metric size. I think it is 6. Next is another set of ham tools. This is the most important tool of the lot. It is called the hammer. And fun fact, a hammer is the only tool that can be used to create another hammer. Also, you can create a lathe with a lathe, but you cannot create any other tool with the same tool. So this is a special one. Then we have these adjustable pliers that can be used to adjust and grip on things. This is a vice grip or a monkey plier. Again, very useful to hold things in place. Next is a nose pin plier. This is a nose pin plier with a bent in the tip. This is used for removing the piston circlips. So very useful tool again. I use it for all nose plier purposes. This is a very useful tool for me. Next is a normal plier, and then we have these circlip pliers. So I have two type of circlip pliers. One is which is used to expand the circlips, and the next one, which is lying next to it, is used to contract and install a circlip. These are for two different type of circlips. Then you have another set of a nose plier and a normal plier. So that's about the pliers that I have. So next one is a set of T-spanners, box spanners, wrenches, pipe wrench, etc., etc. So this is again very useful. These are 8mm spanner. It can also be used to install impact drill bits into it, and this spanner can be used to loosen and tighten stuff as well where you need more leverage. So because it is a useful bit of kit, I actually have two of those. Then I have a chisel. So this chisel is useful to sometimes bend certain washers and also straighten them while taking them off. So very useful tool. The pipe wrench is not very useful in the lot, so I don't use that very much. Maybe I have used one like a couple of months ago. So not a very useful tool in my arsenal, but nevertheless, you never know when you need one. So I used to do a lot of plumbing fixes at home, so that is when I bought this pipe wrench. But not a very useful tool when it comes to your mechanical repairs. Next is a normal combination T spanner. So this one, I have converted it into a tool that can be used to remove the RX100, RX135, RXZ4-speed speedometer worm nut. So this is again a very useful thing for me, but rather a special tool, but I thought I'll cover it here. a flathead screwdriver. So these screwdrivers are not only used to drive screws and remove these, but they are also used to sometimes chisel out certain washers if I don't have the access to insert a chisel. So you have to make sure that you buy a screwdriver with a very, you know, sturdy back. Then you have these Allen keys. So these Allen keys come very handy in certain purposes, but in a bike there are only a few Allen keys. But you know, if you convert all the screws to Allen key on an engine, you need this 5mm Allen key a lot. Then the next most common Allen key is the 6mm. This is what you use to remove the kicker boss on an RX 100, RX 135, RXZ. Shogun Shaolin has a bolt, a 12mm bolt, so not very useful there. Then is a very useful Allen key. This is a 14mm Allen key. This is used to remove the shock absorber or front fork top nuts. This is common for a lot of bikes like Shaolin, Shogun, etc. Then you have a mallet. Usually the mallets have two nylon bushings on both the sides. This is something that is not useful for me because, you know, it broke pretty early in its life. So if you get one, get a rubber mallet. That is better than the screwable nylon mallets, which actually are not that good. So next set of things are the box spanners. So very useful again, but you know, if you are going to an advanced level of rebuild, that is when you need these. Otherwise you can do with normal T-spanners. So I have a 10mm, starting with an 8mm, 10mm I have multiple of those, but like usual, the 10mm, all other ones are missing. I only could find one. Then there is a pivoting head, which is attachment. Then there is 11mm. 11mm is not very common, so you might not need those. Then I have three 13mm. I also have two 12mm. 12mm and 13mm got mixed. So you have 12mm after the 13mm. These are very useful. So if you want to get those, get 12mm and 13mm a lot. Then I have two 14mm. 14mm are also very common in RX. Then there is a 17mm. The main drain bolt of an RX is a 17mm. The oil drain bolt, so you need one. Then there is a 22mm and an 18mm. The 18mm is used for the clutch as well as the crank nuts, so you need one of those as well. Then there is a 22mm. Then the 27 and 30mm are for RD350. The RD350 crank can be removed from a 27mm, and the clutch needs to be removed using a 30mm box. And I also have a ratchet, which you see above. So this ratchet is used in small places where the access is little restricted. There are two handles below, one extended, one extender, one handle, and then there are two Torx bits which are specific for the crews that I have. Next one is, I actually also need to mention that you need three T-spanners, 10, 12 and 13, that's a must. This is a magnet holder. This is a magnet puller for RX 135. The RX 100 one is slightly different, I'll show you that as well. So you bolt this to the magnet and then you turn the top thing and it comes out. This can also be used to install the crank back. If you remove the top screw, you can bolt it. So this is the RX 100 type puller. This can also be used in a Shogun, Shaolin or Samurai. So very useful tool. There is a measuring tape that is also needed, but optional. You know, you need to measure certain things, obviously. So this wire cutting tool is a very versatile tool that I have. It can be used to, you know, snip plastic connectors, cut through, you know, small piece of metal, wires, wire ties. So it's a very nimble tool. I use it a lot. Okay, so the next one is a clutch holder for RX100, RX135. I have two of those because I kind of misplaced one when I had only one and I bought another one. So next one is a pry tool, couple of knives, and then this is used to remove trims, etc. So you can use a flathead screwdriver to do that, but this is better. This is a pinky spanner that is used to tighten and loosen the castle nuts of an RX100 and RD350 silencer bend pipe. This can also be used to tighten and loosen the T-stem of an RX or an RD350 or a Shogun Samurai. Almost all bikes have a T-stem nut that can be tightened using this. So that is again a very useful tool. You need not remove the T-stem completely to tighten this. I've seen some mechanics using a screwdriver and hitting it with a hammer to tighten these, but that's not good. So this is not a tool. This is basically something that I stole from my mother's kitchen. So this is used to drive bearings into the crankcase, and it is also used to drive oil seals. Very good tool. Since it's made of aluminium, it doesn't cause any damage. Next is a scale. Usually steel scale is good for mixing paint, etc. This is a plastic rivet remover, also very common tool. You need it if you're working on cars. Next is an RD350 clutch holder. You need spark plug removers. So these are two plug removal tools. This one comes with the toolbox of an RX100, RX135, RXZ. And the other one is something that I bought from a shop. I use the other one more than the one that came in the toolbox. Then the most favorite tool of mine in this special tool category is definitely going to be the impact screwdriver. So this impact screwdriver is a very versatile tool. You can use this to loosen bolts which are stuck. You can also use them to tighten them. But I don't recommend using impact on engine screws to tighten them because, you know, they will strip. I use them to loosen them. So there are bits like this which you insert at the end and then you hit it with a hammer at the back, and this loosens tough to remove bolts. You can also put a bit in the front and you can also remove bolts using this. Very useful tool. Then there is this special brush which is used to clean the chain. So since it's a special brush, I thought I'll put it amongst the special tools I have. So next set is electrical tools that I have. So the first set of electrical tool that I have is a soldering iron. So this soldering iron is a Stanley make. I bought it recently. Before this, my solder-on iron, which was bought during my college days, used to do the service. So almost 20 years it served me well. After that, it recently passed away, so I had to get a new one. This has removable tips, so it came with two tips. I used this tip a lot, so I keep that installed. Then you have multiple connectors. I like using connectors rather than, you know, just splicing two wires, so these connectors do come handy. Then there is this, the tester. So almost everybody knows what a tester does, but in my scenario I misplace this a lot. So usually when I need to test the face or neutral, I usually check it using my hand. Yes, that is right, I get electrocuted every time I want to find out if, you know, a particular line is phase or neutral. But this is the safest way of doing it. This can also be used to remove the jets, pilot jet, especially in the carburetor. So I have multiple of these as well. Next is the soldering lead, which is self-explanatory. I'm not going to go deep into it. Insulation tape, I have multiple of those as well. Then the next one is actually a very special tool that I created. This is kind of a pricking tool. So this is nothing but a rear brake switch spring. Then this is used to pry open the pins, and, you know, if you want to remove the pin from one slot and insert it in another slot, you just need to insert this like this and the pin comes out from the back, and that's a very handy tool again. Next is a multimeter. You might not need a multimeter unless and until you want to tackle some serious electrical gremlins. So I use it mostly to test continuity of the circuit, and also I use it to check the voltage in the circuit. So multimeter is a good tool, but again, you can avoid it. You can use or buy a continuity tester. So next one is a battery charger. This is used to charge both 6 volt as well as 12 volt battery. It has different ampere, like, you know, 1, 2, 4 and 5. So this can be used for charging batteries. I don't use much. Now we have awesome set of tools. So these are my favorites of the entire set of tools, and I really love these tools, to be very honest. Power tools actually make a man's life very, 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 very easy. So these are my favorites, and if you see, there is a common thing in all the tools. Most are, or almost all are, made by Black & Decker. So I like Black & Decker tools. They are cheap, they are reliable, they are good value for money. So this was the first one that I bought, but not very useful. So I use it as, or a Phillips head screwdriver now. So there is, that head is permanently placed in it because I lose my Phillips head screwdriver a lot. Then we have a heat gun. Heat gun is used to remove the stickers from tank, and then also used to, you know, remove stubborn nuts and bolts. Let's say if something is stuck, you spray it with WD-40 and then heat it with a gun, and then it will easily come out. So this is something that you can use if you don't want to start a fire, to be honest. Next is a very famous tool in my channel. I use this a lot. This is my most favorite tool, and this is one tool that has paid for itself several times over. So this is my cordless drill. But since it doesn't have a hammer action, this is not a great drill, especially to drill through concrete. So this is being used by me as a impact wrench. So I have a half inch adapter fixed in the front, so all my sockets just plug into it, and then car polisher. So this is an adjustable speed car polisher. I don't use it much. I have used it only a couple of times. Next is the tool that I am scared of the most and I love the most. Again, you know, it's a very versatile tool, the angle grinder. So this is a scary tool because these things break and these can easily lodge into your eyes. So be very, 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 very careful when you're using this. Take proper precaution. You put protection on the eye, and then make sure that, you know, you put the shield as well, protective shield. I use it to cut almost everything from wood to steel. So this is again a very versatile tool and a very helpful tool in my arsenal. So that's about the angle grinder. So the next one is actually a tool that I got very recently. So this is concrete drill. So this is, of course, a drill machine. It's a wired drill machine. It is to complement the already existing drill machine that I have. This would help me drill through concrete. So it's a very good drill machine, again from Black & Decker, value for money. This is again another toy that I bought, and I am really in love with this. So if you are a basic DIYer, all you need is just this and the cordless drill that I have. So that can help you take care of a lot of stuff. All the bits come standard. This also has some boxes like 7, 8 and 10, most common ones. Then there are countersink bits, holders for these smaller bits, wood bits. Then on the right side, this is a good knife actually. On the right side, you can see different type of drill, concrete, steel and then wood. So, and it's very well organized. There is a scale in the back, as you can see. And that scale can be used to measure the size of the hole, and depending on that you can take the right bit out of it. It is very organized. I love this, but again, you know, I've seen better. So I know that I have to just wait and this will go all over the place. So, but I'm hoping that I keep it back in this. So yeah, that is my drill bit. And then the next one, which I'm going to show you guys now, is an amazing tool, you know, that is my pressure washer. So this particular pressure washer was bought in 2012 and it has served me well for 8 years, and it has again paid for itself multiple times. This can be used to clean you know, your floor, it can be used to clean your wall, it can be used to clean your car, obviously. So only thing that I have changed so far is the cable as well as the hose, the high pressure hose, because both of them were bitten by the amazing dogs that I have at my home. So these have multiple guns, and then there is a foam gun. Most of you might have seen me use it on my car. So initially, before I had this, I used to wash my car every week. At that time, the car wash used to cost around 250 rupees. Now it is like 400 to 500 rupees. So, you know, this was bought for 7,000, I think. And in the last 8 years, it has paid for itself at least, you know, 100 or 150 times. I wash my cars every week. I wash all my bikes every week. Plus, I wash the car porch and all the surroundings every week. So this is a very helpful tool. So yeah, that is my tool collection. And again, remember, this was not accumulated overnight. Rome was not built in a day. So this is my tool collection, which was accumulated over the last 10 years. So I have lost a lot of tools. Apart from this, I have a bench vise, I have a compressor, but those are not some things that you would need if you are a basic DIYer. So these are the tools that you need. Again, don't get them all at one shot, get them one by one. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and we'll meet you in the next one. Thank you. Bye-bye.